The old proverb, empty vessels make the most noise, is an ancient observation of the phenomena of echo and reverberation. When sound waves impinge on hard surfaces, they are reflected. Often we may hear the reflected waves or echoes a short time after we hear the original source of the sound, like this.
Hello.
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 Are you there, echo?
Are you there, echo?
The time lag between the original sound and the echo depends upon the distance between the sound source and the reflecting surface. Here is how speech sounds accompanied by echo from reflecting surfaces at various distances.
500 feet. You are now listening to speech accompanied by an echo from a reflecting surface 500 feet away. 200 feet. You are now listening to speech accompanied by an echo from a reflecting surface 200 feet away. 50 feet. You are now listening to speech accompanied by an echo from a reflecting surface 50 feet away.
The echo sounds fainter than the source because the original sound energy is spread out and lost, traveling to and from the surface. It's quite possible for echoes to have echoes. Large auditoriums or halls, like empty barrels, often have more than one reflecting surface. Sounds may bounce from wall to wall, that is, reverberate, like this.
Hello.
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 Hello, ladies and gentlemen.
When echoes are numerous and overlapping, they may merge into a babble of noise, making normal speech difficult to understand.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. I am speaking in a hall that reverberates with many echoes.
Biblical legends tell us that inside the famous Tower of Babel, even the words of learned men sounded like nonsense. This could have been a case of poor acoustical design. The tower was made of sun-baked bricks and tiles, which reflected sounds from one wall to another, setting up reverberations that scrambled speech until it was unintelligible.
The tower of Babel sounded like this. The tower of Babel sounded like this.
Reverberation is responsible for the slowness with which sound fades away. It may be controlled by carefully selecting wall materials and coverings to absorb the sound energy. The time it takes a sound to diminish 60 decibels, or 1/1,000,000th of its original intensity, is called reverberation time. We use reverberation time as a measure of the acoustic characteristics of a hall. Listen. I am now speaking in a room that has a reverberation time of several seconds. Rooms which have a reverberation time of several seconds or more may be suitable for some forms of music, but generally they are undesirable for speech. Reverberations fade away more rapidly in small rooms because it takes less time for the sounds to bounce back and forth between the walls and be absorbed. I am now speaking to you in a room which has a reverberation time of only a few tenths of a second. Rooms which are moderately reverberant, that is, having reverberation times of about 1 second for a small auditorium and about 2 seconds for a large auditorium, are usually pleasant for both speakers and listeners.
I am now speaking in an auditorium that has a reverberation time of about 1 second. This auditorium has been specially designed to give satisfactory acoustics no matter where the listener is sitting.
As you can hear, speakers rely on some reverberation to give resonance and sustenance to their voices. If you've ever sung in a bathtub, you will understand how reverberation may make a voice sound better than it really is.